In my early 20s, I got a good corporate job paying me $50,000 a year, and I blew through my entire salary. Even though at the time, that was a lot of money for me. Like, I grew up riding the poverty line, so making $50,000 a year was life-changing. But I was still living paycheck to paycheck. I became a self-made millionaire at the age of 30, and in this video, I want to share with you some of the tips, tools, and strategies that I learned that helped me turn it all around. In part one, I explained the habit loop and how to hack your brain so that you can give it what it actually needs instead of what you think it needs. In part two, I'm going to share with you why restriction, blame, and budgeting was not the solution to my problems. Again, this is probably going to be a pretty long video, but I promise you it is going to change your life. So if you don't have the time to watch it right now, make sure you save it and come back later. So when I first started trying to get my financial shit together, I did something called the jar method. Basically what I did is every time I got paid, I would take out all my money in cash. I put that cash into glass jars that were labeled for each expense. This way I could physically watch all of the money flying out of my life. This way I could shame myself when I saw myself overspending spending in certain categories and having to steal from another one to make up for it. And now all this extreme form of budgeting does is put your brain into scarcity mode and then reaffirm your belief that you're not good with money. And this is a huge problem. Let me explain why. I needed to understand that I was not stuck with money because I couldn't do simple math. There was something deeper going on, and it usually comes back to the thoughts and beliefs you have about yourself and money. All of the results we have in our life come from our actions. And our actions come from our thoughts, and our thoughts come from our beliefs. This is why the statement, whether you think you can or you think you can't, you are right, is so true. Because when you believe something, whether you realize it or not, you will take actions to affirm that belief. If you believe drinking coffee gives you the energy that you need to get through your day, you will drink coffee in the morning. If you believe drinking coffee is bad because it gives you anxiety and sleep problems, you'll probably avoid it. So when you do something like budgeting and then you fail because you're not addressing the real underlying problem, it's just a band-aid approach, you're reinforcing the belief, consciously or not, that you are bad with money. When you believe that you are bad with money, it becomes easier to act as somebody who is bad with money because you'll believe, well, this is just who I am. It's like the broken window theory. The theory states that signs of disorder will lead to more disorder. A building with a broken window that has been left unrepaired will give the appearance that no one cares and that no one is watching, and this will lead to more vandalism. If you believe your life is a mess financially, and it will always be a mess financially, then you will be more likely to avoid taking positive action with your finances because you'll think that your actions are fruitless. They won't have any real result. And you'll be more likely to take negative actions with your money because you'll think, fuck it, this is how it's always going to be, so why not? We have been taught by the big financial heads like Dave Ramsey and Suze Orman that restricting yourself and shaming yourself means you're being responsible. But actually, all you're doing is making it impossible for you to build wealth. Shame and restriction are not conducive to building wealth. They're actually just conducive to building feelings of scarcity, where you will believe that you'll never have enough, even if you do. If you said, hey, I'm only going to eat broccoli for 3 months because I want to lose weight, would you lose weight? Sure. Because you are starving yourself. And the entire 3 months, your body would be aching for something more fulfilling. And more likely than not, you would end up falling off your diet and binge eating Deborah's entire birthday cake in the break room. And if you did make it the 3 months only eating broccoli, you'd probably just gain all of the weight back afterwards. Because eating only broccoli is not sustainable. This is what happened to like all of the contestants that went on The Biggest Loser. Where people would work out 3 times a day and eat basically nothing to lose weight, and then leave the show and end up putting even more weight back on. Now your brain, it can't tell the difference between actual scarcity, like living in poverty, and perceived scarcity. And studies show that effects of scarcity on your brain can be the same as alcoholism or not sleeping for an entire evening. And when your brain is bogged down like that, it means that you don't have the capacity to make good decisions. And that hinders your ability to hit your goals. That is the complete opposite of what you want. So when you're constantly telling your brain that you don't have enough, like you do when you binge budget, it starts to believe that you don't have enough and that the stress of those feelings prevent you from planning accurately for the future. Because you are so worried and so stressed about the here and now. It's like running your computer with 50,000 tabs open. It gets bogged down. It doesn't run properly. This may cause you to do things like not paying off your credit card debt, even though you have the cash available to do it, because you don't want to see the money leave. This will prevent you from doing things like investing for your retirement because you don't feel like that money will come back to you, or cause you to binge spend all of your money today buying things because you feel like you'll never have the opportunity again in the future. Budgets are not the solution. They are a band-aid approach. To see real success with your money, you need to get to the root cause of what's causing you to be stuck. Now, in part three, I want to talk to you about some tips that I use to stop myself from getting in my own damn way and self-sabotaging all the time. Because even when I knew what I was supposed to do, I wasn't doing it. So come back for part three. And if you want to keep learning about money, check out our link in bio. We have 4 free trainings available. They are incredible and they will help you get started on this financial journey. Let's go.